Good morning, everybody. Here is Eva Speaks again. Today's topic is about how to trust in love again. I chose this topic not only because of quite disastrous ending of my own relationship, but as well what I heard from many people and as well people who I support or inspire, how to get trust again. You know that mostly all of us take our past in our new relationship, and usually people who are divorced or went through different difficulties during the relationship or challenges tend to get the past back when they feel a bit tension or not comfortable. And very often we start to complain about our previous partner or how wrong did he or she was in a relationship. Remember that all of these are only projection of our own self and reaction, how we see each other, not only in the relationship but as well in the world. And you know that when we let go to change somebody, we also start to understand ourselves better. Of course, that everything starts with a beautiful feeling and we want to hold on this feeling. But how do you feel about yourself? We force the other one that he or she will love us unconditionally. But how it is about our own self-love and self-care? And this is the root cause why we don't trust. The root cause is also how do we express ourselves? How do we use the communication to the other one? When we suppress our feelings, we also limit our own ability how we feel. And this, of course, will turn into limitation and ability to trust ourselves. And when we don't trust ourselves, how can we trust the others? And a lot of people jump from one relationship to the other, and they don't even realize that they have to heal themselves first. Women somehow start to be more conscious, and even though that a lot of people, when they cannot trust in love anymore, they start to play a victim, which is also a very, very bad choice. And when we start to play a victim, we try to express or to get a recognition or somehow attention from the other one. But we are only projecting our own energy. And you know that energy is everything, what also Albert Einstein said. And energy and motion is emotion. And if we don't have enough energy, then there will also not be the right emotion. Then if we judge the other one all the time without any explanation why we do it, we have to start to look in the mirror what's going on there. What we have to do to clear, to heal, to be more responsible about where we are. And what I've already said, if we don't trust ourselves, That's why we don't trust the others. And trust is, of course, also a part of self-love, self-esteem, and self-care. Trust is also to know yourself, to be in a connection with yourself. I heard it so many times that people are disconnected. They cannot find a connection with themselves. Why are you then searching continuously for a new Coca-Cola relationship? You've heard it from me already before. That's when you get high in your emotion for a very, very short period of time, and then it disappears because we don't know ourselves. We are not connected. We don't know what it is to be in a present moment. We are all the time thinking about how she or he could behave, how he or she could change, how he or she did something wrong, or did say or didn't say something. And these are really the root causes. Not to project to the other one, but to look at ourselves first. And we also stop trust in love when we are hurt in a way that the words don't match with the reality. And I know a lot of women I'm talking with, because the last time I did some interviews as well, a lot of women struggle with this, that men say something and it looks like they don't mean it. I say, even though it looks like that they didn't mean it, I think that they meant it in the past, when the emotion was at the highest level in the beginning. But then the trust started to disappear. And again, I repeat, this is because the man was not connected with himself, did not trust himself, and he lost control in the relationship, because there was no relationship with himself. So my conclusion is, don't take your past in your new relationship. Feel instead of see. Look and feel instead of saying words which you can get a regret of. Can you feel the person? Can you feel the spirit of the other one? A lot of us live only on a very superficial level instead of going inside. Learn to know yourself. Heal your inner child first and be fully responsible for your own action and yourself. And if you let go your past, you heal your inner child. You can start a new chapter of your life on a totally different level. And then you start to understand what is love about. And then, of course, you start to love yourself even better and make the other one happier in your true, unconditional, loving relationship. Thank you for listening. It was just my thought at this moment, and I hope you enjoyed it, and I will prepare another nice podcast or video next time. Bye bye.